I see. There are a finger. We can take a couple of questions at the same time, and then Bogdan can answer. Please stand up so we can see you really well. Please stand up so we can see you well.
Yeah. You mentioned the Dutch Sustainable Growth Coalition. I remember that Shell was one of them also. How do you look to them at the moment?
And I've received this question earlier.
Oh, is it?
I will reply to that. Yeah.
Okay.
Shell, others?
Any others who would like to have a question based on what you just heard? Yes.
I was wondering, how optimistic are you to that the world will reach these targets of the Paris conference in the next 5 years? Because we only have 5 years, as you mentioned. So I was wondering on your perspective.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah. And the third one, and then Mr. Balkan will answer these three.
Could you please give an example of corporate social entrepreneurship by EY, where you work?
My own company, yes.
Okay. Mr.
That's a very good question. All questions are okay. First, about Shell. I can imagine your question. Because Shell is a company that is busy, in fact, in the traditional sector, fossil fuels, etc. They are in our midst, and I think it's good that they are there, because we have discussions with each other about what's the future. I think that the profile of companies like DSM, AkzoNobel, Philips is different, that's true. I spoke about that with the people of Shell, and they said, in any case, the first thing you have to do is replacing coal by gas. That's one step. The second step in the business model, more gas activities than oil activities. But the next step has to be made, and that's about renewables. And we've seen in early days, when Jeroen van der Veer was CEO, that there were investments in the renewables, but later on it was brought down. And I really hope that, but that's not my responsibility, also Shell will take up its responsibility regarding these new activities. You know that they are busy with a tender now about the offshore windmill park, so that this can be first step, but I really hope they will do more, because we are living in a time of transition and we need those companies, but you have to change your business model. That's up to them, but I can imagine your question. That's also a point of debate in our organization. Then the question, are you optimistic? It's a very good one. Let's say, sometimes I receive the criticism, you are so optimistic about the developments. Well, I can do it another way, ladies and gentlemen. I'm aware of the fact that the world is changing. And of course, there are new views, but it's so difficult. I can give such a speech, but that has no use. I really believe in the fact that we have to change things. That's the reason why maybe I'm sound a bit optimistic. But you're completely right. A few years ago, there was an analysis of Global Compact, that's the business network of the United Nations, and of MIT Sloan, two research reports. And the question was, how successful are we in implementing sustainability into business models? And then the analysis was, we are on a kind of plateau. After years in which there was much more attention for sustainability, suddenly the CEO said, we are on a plateau. Yeah, we have some pilot projects, but making a real business model of it is a bit difficult. And this has to change. What I notice, I'm traveling a lot around the world. When I'm in Japan, many companies already are busy with a strategy. In China, it's necessary. A country like Korea, they have an organization called Global Green Growth Institute. When I attended Temasek, a Singaporean investment company, they start with a stewardship and corporate governance center. And I asked the people, why do you have such a stewardship center? The remark was, all our directors must receive a training, because they take decisions on the investments every day, and they must be able to lay connection with sustainability issues. When you're in South Africa, you talk with business people. Many countries in Africa have a lack of good governance. So it's also up to these companies to do the right things for society, and you can have beautiful stories. But we're not there. And let's say what keeps me busy at this moment is that a few years ago, we spoke about the BRICS. Lots of criticism around Europe. And then Russia, Brazil, etc. Now you see Russia has difficulties, Brazil has difficulties, South Africa has difficulties, China not double-digit growth. And suddenly we discover that Europe is a rather reliable haven to invest. So that's one issue, what's happening in the global scale. We have the migration issue at the moment, refugees is a complicated one. We have tensions between countries, we have Ukraine issue, etc. And let's say, if you'd ask me, what was the best moment for you in the international arena as Prime Minister, that was March 2009. I attended the G20 meeting in London. And then people said, within 1 year, we must finalize the WTO negotiations. We must make a success of Copenhagen. We must have a new financial architecture. There was a kind of awareness of all the heads of government to say, we have to change things. And at this moment, the atmosphere is totally different. And that concerns me, I must say. And we're running out of time, so I'm optimistic because I see a lot of people in the world, business people, who are willing to change things. That gives me hope. And we need these people, but also you see a lot of difficulties and developments that are hindering the progress and realizing sustainability business practices. So it's a bit a double answer. The last remark about my own company, what happened? I'm a happy former politician. For me, it was an honor to be invited to work at EY. And why? I received the invitation to work on the corporate responsibility practice. But what I noticed is that also my company is really in a process of change. And it's not business usual any longer. Let me give some examples. The first was we had to define our own strategy, the four E's: entrepreneurship, employees, environment, community engagement. That was the general idea. And later on, we developed our strategy and also we had our KPIs for that. And then we discussed the issue with the auditors. As I said, the role of auditors is changing. So we have the obligation that auditors talk about integrated reporting with their clients. I already mentioned the issue of tax. The discussion about taxation is different now. It's about fair taxation. What are you doing? Avoid tax avoidance, etc. We have our TOS people, transaction specialists. It's for the start of discussion, but the question today is, what is the value of a company? And if you are excluding the issues around sustainability and the measurement of the value of a company, you are not measuring the right way. So that's the type of discussion we have among our transaction specialists. And then we have the advisory component. Even when we had difficult economic times, we had to take over of BECO. So suddenly we had 50 or 60 extra sustainability specialists. It was an investment of my company to say we must do deliver more activities for our clients. So we have an internal role that has to do with, let's say, the workplace of the future. We have new ability schemes, let's say they use, everyone is using cars, etc. The buildings. But the fundamental question is, what are the core activities and can you see the difference? And we are in process of transition. And what I noticed since 2011, since I work at EY, a CR policy. More attention for, let's say, the family businesses. More attention now for everything around big data. So what I see, we are in a constant process of change, and I like that very much, I must say. So that's an element of hope. So for me, it's great to work at such a company. That's the reason why I'm looking back with satisfaction time I was Prime Minister. I really enjoyed it, but I don't miss it, and I think that's the right balance, and it has to do with the work at EY. And besides that, it's necessary also to speak of young people. That was the reason why, in any case, I want to become professor again, because I like to give lectures to speak of young people, not only in the Netherlands, but everywhere in the world. That's always good. The most important thing is that, let me repeat about reinventing. Reinventing as a company means rethink your business model, the way you're doing things. But also in your personal life, always think, what can I do in another way? I had a taxi driver in Athens, and I spoke about his life. I said, what do you think about people here? And then he said, a lot of people are not taking any initiatives. They receive 500 euros, and that's it. He said, I have three jobs. And his remark was, and he said, never stay in your comfort zone. Always try to get out of it. And he demonstrated that he wanted to make progress in his own life. And I think making progress in your life, and that also counts for companies, institutions, progress must be seen in relationship with the sustainability components. And that's the reason why it's important to talk about the question, what's your legacy? How are you contributing towards society? The policy of my company is called Building a Better Working World. It's also connected with that. And when I ask young people, what makes you happy? Of course, it has to do with health, etc. But I think the best thing is when you can serve others, that can make you happy. And maybe it's not so common in the business world, but I think it's really necessary. Well, how can you contribute to have a better society? And if not, then we get a lot of problems. Let me talk about the new economy. When we talk about, let's say, robotics, we have to think about job creation in the longer run. We have to talk about upward mobility, about the middle class. What about quality of life? I think that's also a part now of the sustainability agenda. So I think the great thing today is we have a lot of knowledge. We have exponential growth of knowledge, but you have to use it in the right way. And it must be in a sustainable way. And therefore, it's important to talk about these issues, corporate responsibility in the boardroom, disruptive thoughts, but especially entrepreneurial action. We need action today. Thank you very much.